Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video terminal value formula, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon that's given below. Well, today we have a topic that is a capital budgeting topic where it's basically valuation, but you know, terminal value formula is a part of valuations, different sort of valuations that you do, which is a part of the discounting cash flow. Again, discounting cash flow is another subset of valuation, and terminal value formula is something what we are going to learn today. So let's begin. Over here, terminal value formula is the last cash flow, that is free cash flow, upon, that is divided by 1 plus weighted average cost of capital. Here, summation of 1. I'll teach you how exactly it is done. So what is terminal value formula and DCF? Well, see, terminal value is defined as the value of the investments at the end of a specific period. Now, terminal value formula helps to estimate the value of a business. Okay. It helps you to estimate the value of the business beyond the explicit forecast period. So, the formula for the calculation of the terminal value formula in DCF is as follows. How does it work? FCFF divided by 1 plus WAC, that is weighted average cost of capital. T over here that I showed you, raised to T here. Okay, T here is the time. WAC is weighted average cost of capital or the discounting rate. And FCFF is the free cash flow to the firm. Well, the terminal value is the present value of all the future cash flow, and it is mostly used in the discounted cash flow analysis. Now, there are three methods for calculating the terminal value formula. One is called the perpetuity method. Second is the exit multiple method. The third is the no growth perpetual method. We'll start with the first one. Perpetuity growth method. The perpetuity growth method is also known as the Gordon's growth perpetual formula. Okay. So, this is the most preferred method. In this method, you know, the assumption is made that the growth of the company will continue and the return of the capital will be more than the cost of the capital. That is, R will be greater than the weighted average cost of capital. That is return. So, the terminal value is calculated as your FCFF of the sixth year, let's say, that is the final year or around that, divide by 1 plus WAC, okay, raised to 6. Okay, close the bracket and that will be raised to 6. Again, this will remain the same plus, so this will be an addition to that. FCFF was 7 raised to 7. And this whole will be, this complete will be divided by, this complete will be divided by 1 plus WAC of or WAC raised to 7. That is the final terminal value, the terminal discounting rate. So, if we simplify the terminal value formula, it will be terminal value is the simple as that. FCFF of the sixth year divided by WAC minus the growth rate, which is the Gordon's formula. So, FCFF can be written as FCFF 6 is equal to FCFF of 5 into 1 plus growth rate. Now, use a terminal value formula in the above equation. So, how will you get the answer? So, the terminal value formula will be equal to your FCFF of 5th year into 1 plus growth rate divided by WACC minus growth. Okay, so you're moving this ahead. You're moving this ahead to the sixth by growing it up. You're adding the growth in that. Divided by WACC divided by G. So this is your FCFF 6, right? So this method is used for companies which are mature in the market and have stable growth. Example like FMCG companies, automobile companies, and so on and so forth. Now let's discuss the second one. The second is the exit multiple method. What is exit multiple method? See, exit multiple method is used with the assumption of what? It is used with the assumption that the market multiple bases to value business, and the terminal value can be the enterprise value divided by your EBITDA, or probably your enterprise value divided by EBIT. Instead of this, you can use your EBITDA, that is earning before interest and tax, which are the usual multiple used in the financial valuation. So the projected statistics is relevant statistics that is projected in the previous year. So the terminal value formula is equal to last 12 months TVM, last 12 months terminal multiple into projected statistics. The third method is called the no growth perpetuity model. Well, the no growth perpetuity model is used in the industry where a lot of competition is there and the opportunity to earn excess return tends to move to zero, right? So in this formula, the assumption is the growth rate, and that is equal to zero. This means that the return on the investment will be equal to the R will be equal to the cost of capital. Okay. So the terminal value formula, that is TVF, that will be equal to FCFF 6 divided by WACC. So it is useful to calculate the GDP of the country. I'm just giving an example where exactly this is used. Now, we'll take an example of the terminal value formula, right? I'll show you a template so that will be an easy. Let's see some simple examples to calculate the terminal value equation in DCF to understand it better. Let's say in a metal sector, let's say it is trading at 10 times. The metal sector is basically, let's say it is trading at the 10 times of the EV by EBITDA multiple. Then the terminal value is 10 into EBITDA of the company. Now let us do the calculation of the terminal value formula by an example. Suppose, let's say your WACC is 10%, growth rate is 4, that is your G, your debit balance is 100, cash is 60, and number of shares is 200. Let me show you. So this is how your table will look like: 2015, 2016, 2017 numbers. Then you have your EBIT, free cash flow to the firm. This is how you forecast it. So forecasted EBIT into 1 minus tax, that is your you're basically deducting your tax. This will be a post-tax EBIT, right? You add depreciation in that, less capex and change in working capital, which will give you your FCFF. You have been given your WACC and your growth rate, and based on this you will have to find per share fair value of the stock using the two proposed terminal value formula. Well, using the perpetuity method, how things will look like? The step one is to calculate the NPV of the free cash flow of the firm to explicit forecast method. So first, what we will do after getting all this, you will calculate the NPV. NPV of what? Your B13, that is your WACC, you will take into picture, and the cash flows will be from E10 to your forecasted, all your forecasts, net present value of the explicit forecast period, right? So you will take that, which will give you 127 as your net present value for the period of 2018 to 2020. Step 2 will be to calculate the terminal value calculation at the end of 2018, okay? And then you'll add both. So the terminal value will be the last, okay? Perpetual growth method, you will take the last cash flow 60 into 1 plus growth rate divided by VAC minus G. So you'll get the last growth rate using the perpetuity growth method. Terminal value will be 1040. And then finally, the step 3, the present value of the explicit FCFF, where VAC is 10%, growth 4%. So in that scenario, you will add both of them, perpetual growth method and the terminal value, and then you will calculate the NPV of this entire, okay, with the help of the VAC, that gives you 781. Now step 4 is that, you know, calculate the enterprise value and the share price, right? So the present value of the explicit FCFF is 127, terminal value is 781, add both of them, less debt, add cash, so that will give you your equity value, divide by number of shares, that will give you the share price, which is the price you were looking for. So here, you note that this is an example of terminal value contribution to the enterprise value, which is 86%. Generally, the contribution is between 80 to 90%. Now, this is the terminal value using exit multiple growth, right? So same thing, EV by EBITDA, simply first, after exit multiple, you have found your terminal value with the help of G3 plus G7. G3 plus your depreciation. You add your EBIT plus depreciation into 7x, because that is the EV by EBITDA. We will find the terminal value, right? So based on that, you can calculate your step number 3 to calculate the present value of the explicit FCFF, right? VAC, growth, exit multiple. You take the NPV of this, you will get the present value, the explicit FCFF, and then the whole thing remains the same. I hope you have got a fantastic idea how we have done things here. Now, what is the relevance of this? Relevance of this and the uses. Well, it is used in the financial tools like Gordon Growth method to calculate the DCF, okay, example same we have seen above, and to calculate the residual method, or basically to calculate your residual earnings. So terminal value is an important concept in estimating the discounting cash flow, as it accounts around 60 to 80% of the total value of the company. Special attention it should be given to in assuming the growth rate, discount rate, and the multiple, like, you know, PE, price to book ratio, PB ratio, okay, PEG ratio, and EV by EBITDA ratio, EV by EBIT. So there are some of the limitations of the terminal value formula is, you know, the discounting cash flow. So if you use the exit multiple, then we are mixing the DCF approach with the relevant valuation approach, as the exit multiple is arrived from the comparable firm. And you need to note that the growth cannot be greater than your VAC, that is your discounting rate. Always make sure this. Now, the terminal value contributes more than 75% of the total value of this becomes risky. So, if the value varies a lot with even 1% change in the growth or VAC. So, the terminal value includes the value of the cash flow, even though it is not considered in the particular period, but it is difficult to calculate the same with other financial model. And hence, the terminal value formula is used. And that's why the terminal value formula is the value of the company's expected free cash flow beyond the period of the explicit projected financial model. I hope, guys, you have got a fantastic idea about this of this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone, once again, and cheers.